One focus of a hyperbola is located at the point 1, minus 3. Corresponding directrix is y equal to 2. Now you need to find out equation of hyperbola whose eccentricity is 3 by 2. Now we'll do one by one. First, focus is given by 1, minus 3. Directrix is y is equal to 2 or y minus 2 equal to 0. Eccentricity is equal to 3 by 2. Now, conic definition says, by definition, SP is equal to E times PM. SP square is equal to E square PM square. SP square, assume that P x comma y be any point. So, x minus 1 whole square, y plus 3 whole square is equal to E square 9 by 4 into y minus 2 by root of 0 plus 1 square whole square. This is x minus 1 whole square plus y plus 3 whole square equal to, it is y minus 2 whole square. Cross multiplication, 4 into x square plus y square minus 2x plus 6y, this is 9 plus 1, 10, is equal to 9 into y square plus 4 minus 4y. Now simplification, 4x square plus 4y square minus 8x plus 24y plus 40 equal to 9y square plus 36 minus 36y. Now 4x square as it is, 9y square coming over here minus 5y square. Now minus 8x is there, nothing is there on the right hand side. Plus 24y minus 36 is there, be careful, 24, 36 makes totally 60. So 60y, now plus 40 minus 36 minus plus 4 equal to 0. So this is the equation of hyperbola. Now coming to second problem here, e comma even are the eccentricities of hyperbola and its conjugate, prove that 1 by e square plus 1 by e1 square equal to 1. Earlier we did this result. Let us do once again. So eccentricity of hyperbola is e is equal to square root of a square plus b square by a square. Now eccentricity of conjugate hyperbola is e1 is equal to root of a square plus b square by b square. Now you write 1 by e square plus 1 by e1 square equal to a square by a square plus b square by a square plus b square is equal to a square plus b square divided by a square plus b square equal to 1. Therefore, 1 by e square plus 1 by e1 square equal to 1. This is the result we need to prove. Now, coming to third question, he says eccentricity of hyperbola is 5 by 4. That means e is equal to 5 by 4. We need to find out eccentricity of conjugate hyperbola. We can use this result. That means e1 is equal to question mark. Write down 1 by 25 by 16 plus 1 by e1 square equal to 1. 16 by 25 plus 1 by e1 square equal to 1. 1 by e1 square equal to 1 by 16 by 25. That is 9 by 25. E1 square equal to 25 by 9. Implies e1 is equal to 5 by 3. So this is the eccentricity of conjugate hyperbola.